Hello friends, welcome back to my channel. Today I'll be showing you how to make Gujarati white curry. Now this Gujarati white curry is a must have in their daily diet. So let's move on to the ingredients. Here I have taken 2 cups of curd, 3 cups of water, salt to taste, 1 garlic roughly chopped, jaggery. You can use sugar instead, but I would prefer jaggery. And I have taken a little more than a half teaspoon, 1 teaspoon of ginger chili paste. Now if you don't have a ginger chili paste in your house, then you can take a half inch or 1/4 inch of ginger and 1 green chili, grind it together, or you can just grind it with this, because all these ingredients we are going to grind together. And this is 3 tablespoon of gram flour. Now moving to this tadka, I have taken 1 piece of cinnamon stick, few cloves, 1 dry red chili. This chili is very hot, so that's why I'm adding only 1, but if you like more of red chilies, you can add a pinch of fenugreek seeds or methi dana, 1/4 teaspoon of cumin seeds or zeera, and 1/4 teaspoon of mustard seeds or raita. So we'll first start by grinding all the ingredients. So the very first ingredient that goes is yogurt, then goes besan or gram flour, garlic, salt to taste, ginger chili paste, and the jaggery as well. If you like, you can do the taste test while it is boiling, so that time we can add more of jaggery or sugar and salt. So now I'll blend this along with 3 cups of water. So now I've moved the curry to a pan on a high heat, and I'm going to let it boil. So the moment you see a lot of bubbles coming up, you are going to reduce the flame and let it boil on that flame, slow flame, for at least 5 minutes, because now you see this is very runny and you have to keep on stirring it in the middle, because the heat as well as the curd as well as the besan have a tendency to move out, or you know, boil up very fast, and they usually come out of the pan. So you're going to just keep on stirring it in intervals, and after 5 or 7 minutes I will show you what is the consistency. Now after exactly 7 to 8 minutes, this curry is boiling. So now I'm going to reduce the flame and let it boil on a slow flame for 10 minutes. So now you see this curry has thickened a bit. Now in your case, if suppose the curry is taking too much long to thicken, so you could add 1 tablespoon of more of besan or gram flour. Now moving on to the tadka, first we are going to add cinnamon and the cloves, as well as the fenugreek seeds. We'll let the fenugreek seeds brown a bit, and then we will add the chilies and cumin and the red chili. Cumin and chili and the red chili. Once they have sizzled, we will add the tadka to the curry. I will switch off the flame now and add this tadka to the curry. Give it a good mix and let it boil on a high flame for 3 minutes. I added a handful of coriander leaves, and if you feel the spiciness is less, you could add a green chili which I have slitted from the middle and add it to the curry, so it will impart some spiciness to the curry. The curry is ready and now we will plate it. Now the curry is ready. Serve it with steamed rice or just plain white rice, or with zira rice. You can check my link for how to make zira rice in the restaurant style. And do let me do try it, let me know, and do like and subscribe my channel. Thank you.